if I had him. Bitch, that's my trash. Shoot a maid, so you bagged him.
That's gravity, young mate.
How much do you think I can get for my kidney?
Sassy, moody, nasty, yeah. Acting stupid, what's happening? What's happening? Bitch, I'm a
No one's coming.
I know you may be universally despised in this establishment, but they barely know me. Please help!
Mr. Jarvis, how would you feel if we smashed that mirror with this table?
I would feel splendid about it.
All right, we pick it up, and then on the count of three...
Battering ram.
Ready?
One, two...
Wait. What if there are people behind this mirror that we're breaking?
Then they may get hurt. There'll be a spray of glass.
I see. One, two... No, wait. What if these hypothetical people behind the mirror have guns?
Then we may get hurt. There'll be a spray of bullets.
I see. One, two, three! No people. Everybody wins.
I've just thought of something.
We're still attached to a table.
We are still attached to a table.
What the hell is going on in here?
Where is Chief Dooley?
So what next? Miss Carter?
Quiet. Procedure 791. Isolate the suspect and remove civilians from harm before attempting arrest.
I'm sorry, what's happening?
The man at the counter is Agent Mesner from Washington, D.C. The man behind me is Agent Reese.
SSR agents?
I need you to find a way to block the front door so that no one else can come in. I'll do the rest.
I'd love to.
Oh, 10 cents for a cup of coffee. Believe it.
Yes, it's a good day for singing a song, and it's a good day for moving along. Yes, it's a good day. How could anything be wrong? A good day from morning till night.
I can't hold it forever.
For shining your shoes, and it's a good day for losing the blues. Everything begins.
That way, Miss Carter.
A good day.
Right there, Carter. No sudden movements. Got. Those idiots from D.C. didn't believe me when I said you'd be hard to grab.
What's happening, Jack?
Witness places you with Brandis the night he died. There's a photo of you in the club the night Spider Raymond was killed. And here you are with your best friend, Howard Stark's butler.
I think there's been a terrible misunderstanding.
Stuff it!
You got it all wrong.
Then turn yourself in. Come to the office and tell me all about it.
You know I can't do that.
Sweetheart, look around. You don't have a choice.
I'm so sorry, Jack. The Dublin House, 79th Street. Meet me there.
Meet you there? Where are you going?
There's something I need to get from the Griffiths.
That's a horrible idea. It's the first place I look for you. What could you possibly need?
Steve's blood. Go!
Margaret Carter, you're under arrest for treason, espionage, and aiding and abetting public enemy number one, Howard Stark.
There's more to this, Daniel. More than you can understand.
From where I'm standing, it's looking pretty cut and dry.
You're not going to shoot me.
Peggy, don't run. If you run, I'll know it's true.
I'm sorry, Daniel.
Hey, What apartment is Peggy Carter in?
Officer, if I gave every girl's information out to every Tom, Dick, and Gary who came in here, what are you doing? Get out of there. That's confidential.
She's in 3E.
Let's go.
What? Men are not allowed above the lobby. It's a safety issue. I want your badge numbers and the name of your immediate supervisor.
Search everywhere. Bag everything. It all comes with us.
Oh, my wall. I knew she was trouble the minute I laid eyes on her. Those girls from the telephone company are all the same. Oh.
She's here. Somewhere. I know it.
Okay. But where?
What are you doing?
Miss Martinelli, federal agents, we have some questions for you.
They're here for me.
Miss Martinelli, open up.
Oh, you don't look like federal agents.
We're with the Strategic Scientific Reserve.
Well, I'm with the Queens County 4-H. I'm taking down the hall.
I suggest you take them seriously, Miss Martinelli. Miss Carter is not who she appears to be.
She has to face the very walls of this institution.
Mother Hen here says you're friends with Peggy Carter?
Yeah, we're friendly.
She ever tell you about her work?
At the phone company. Just the usual stuff. Complained about her fathead male co-workers a lot.
Did you keep weird hours? Stay out late? Bring guys over?
Of course not. Curfew's at 10. No guys above the lobby.
Here, here.
When was the last time you saw her?
A little bit ago. She was on her way out, said she wasn't going to be around for a while.
Did she say anything else? Like where she was going?
No, she didn't say. But I think it had something to do with her sick grandmother.
Oh, gee, please don't do that.
It's just that her grandmother is doing poorly. And whatever I think about her makes me think of my nana, who's so supportive of my acting career. I perform for her and she says, "You belong on stage, Angel," even though I'm living hand to mouth. And I
Please stop. Could you do something here?
Actors wear their emotions close to the surface. I could no more stop her than I could Laurence Olivier.
What's your grandmother's name?
Gam Gam.
We should go talk to some more of the neighbors. Come on, Tom.
They're there.
Well, I hope you're happy making my tenants cry. To think my taxes pay for your incompetence.
Take Miss Fry to her office. Keep her there.
No. Just a minute.
For your own safety.
My gut says Peggy's close.
All right, then let's find her.
Come here. I want the entire building canvassed. If Carter's here, by God, we're gonna find her.
Oh, Angie, you're amazing. I knew you didn't work at the phone company. Got off the phone with my brother. He's gonna drop a car off at the Dublin House for you. Should at least get you out of town for a while.
Thank you, Angie.
also told my father to stuff secretary school. I belong on Broadway.
After the performance I just saw, there's no way you should be doing anything else. You're an amazing actress.
You're not so bad yourself. Well, I look forward to hearing what this is about someday.
Someday. Take care of yourself.
You too, English.
Peggy? Oh, gosh, Peggy, you're a sight for sore eyes. You know there's a bunch of scary men here looking for you?
Hi, Dottie. Sorry, I was just actually on my way out.
Oh, well, sure, yeah. Well, I'll see you at dinner tonight?
Not tonight. I've made other arrangements.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case, you have a great night, Peg.
No. Oh. You're wearing my brand.
Your own safety, stand back.
Oh, gosh, mister, can you help? I think my friend Peggy must have fainted.
Careful.
Can you help?
She's out. What happened?
Oh, I don't know. I just found her like this.
Jack, a little help?
Sit her up.
She's unconscious. Do we really need those?
Trust me. We need them.
Oh, gosh, I hope she's okay. Should I call an ambulance?
Thank you, miss. We'll take care of it from here.
Grab a pocketbook. Come on, Carter. Let's go.
Explain everything. All of it.
Sit.
This isn't necessary.
You put three SSR agents in the hospital today. So yeah, it's necessary.
Go easy on her just because she's a girl.
Let's get started.
Hey, go easy on those beans, okay?
Coast is clear. Me and Ramirez are on the night watch. We should be good to go at first light.
Which means we stand relieved.
You see any abominable snowmen like the one in Tibet?
I never said abominable snowman.
In fairness, he did specify Yeti.
Yeah.
Sorry, it was a little hard to make out words in between all the sobbing.
Shut up, it was scary. So what is the difference between a Yeti and an abominable snowman?
One's real and one isn't.
What?
So I hear they have mermaids in Japan. You see any of them when you're out there?
Yeah. Story time. I got nothing you guys ain't heard before. Did a lot of groundwork, dug a lot of trenches.
They don't give out Navy crosses just for digging trenches.
Navy cross. All right. 1945. Sukin Island, nothing detailed. Fall asleep on the night shift. I wake up. Six Japanese soldiers walking into my camp. He's waltzing in the dark. One of them bends down over my sleeping CO. One more second, he slit his throat. Snap two. Shoot him in the back. Shoot them all. Before they even knew I was there. Before my last man was even awake. Truth be told, I like the Kid's Yeti story better.
Guys in there wish they could play the game half as well as you.
I'm not playing a game. I never was.
Tell that to Kuzminski!
You know, if you want to hit me, now's your chance.
I don't want to do that, Carter. Something's not right here. I saw what you did in Russia.
What you did. That mission, what you did for me.
You saved my life. This doesn't add up.
That's because I had nothing to do with Kuzminski's death or the theft of Howard Stark's inventions.
Theft? Wow, he's really got you wrapped around his finger, doesn't he? I gotta give it to him. He's as good as they say.
As good as they say?
He got in so deep, he scrambled your brain.
Howard Stark has never scrambled my mind or any other part of me.
Come off it, Carter. There is no harm in admitting that he and you have a thing going on, or had. Because from the look of it, Stark's hung you out to dry. Listen to me. You need to make a deal. Stark is the one we want. Just tell us about him. Save yourself.
The only thing I could possibly tell you about him is he is not the man you want. But the SSR is myopic when it comes to Howard Stark, which is why I have been conducting my own investigation.
That's not entirely true. Before Sousa sniffed you out, we were starting to explore other avenues.
Then by all means, let's stroll down another avenue. What would you like to discuss?
Give us something. Anything.
Tell me what you know about this. What, you don't want to explain this? Fine. Let's go a little further in the past. I want to talk about the Battle of Finnau.
Very well. But you'll be the one that's doing all the talking because I saw no action in Finnau.
That worked out good for you. Because most of the people that served there are dead, except for a few of your Russian buddies.
You think you know me, but I've never been more than what each of you has created. To you, I'm a stray kitten left on your doorstep to be protected. The secretary turned damsel in distress. The girl on the pedestal transformed into some daft whore.
You're behaving like children.
What's worse, what's far worse, is that this is just shoddy police work. You were inches away from the woman that you want when you loaded me into your car. You should be looking for Dottie Underwood, who by now I assume has shed her alias.
Nick's back there. You saved mine.
Not bad for a codebreaker.
Pretty bad for the Navy Cross winner.
Everybody freezes sometimes. You recovered. That's the most important thing.
They were carrying a white flag. The soldiers that came into my camp in Okinawa. Ones I killed. They were coming to surrender. I just didn't realize it until it was too late.
buried the flag before anyone else saw it. Everybody thinks that I'm this guy that I never was. And every day, it gets harder and harder to live with. I've been trying to tell that story since I came home from war.
You just did.
That we're out of control, and some say we're sinners, but don't let them ruin our beautiful rhythms. Fire or fire, we're normally cool,
but there's much desire.